Hey you guys, let's do lunch and have a story time. Husband, bless his heart. I was such a crazy person that if I had married somebody like myself, I do not think I could have stayed married to them. And I'm serious. But my husband's, he's 22 years older than myself. And he's just the best at everything. In a nutshell, he's awesome at everything. When we got married, this is just a handful of things I can remember. Right after we had gotten engaged, and well, not engaged, we just got married in the summer of 82 and bought our first home together, November of 82. So we'd been married in July, August, September, October, not quite 4 months. Talking about, this is a brand new house. What, like, what do you mean all these things you're gonna do? And again, it came from a mature mind, and I was thinking from an immature mind. So he was talking about two of the craziest things I remember. Screaming bloody murder. I was so mad. insisted that we needed a extra refrigerator in the garage. I was screaming my head off. Even now, I said, number one, there's just two of us. How much food do you think two of us are going to need that we're going to have an extra refrigerator? And this is the craziest part. Said, how are we going to afford? How are we going to afford the electricity for an added refrigerator? Now, at that point, if I was my husband, I would have freaked out thinking, who did I marry? So, his voice got kind of shy. Well, at least we could have drinks and a bunch of fresh fruit and nice things if we have company over, because you know we're going to have a lot of friends and family over once we get a new house. And I'm shaking my head. You just don't understand. And honestly, he should have, right then and there, he should have raised his voice and said, no, you don't understand. And he did kind of question me. He said, what do you mean? What do you mean electricity from an extra refrigerator? I said, well, you're already talking about getting a fancier dishwasher when there's already one in there in the house. I don't even know why you need a dishwasher anyways. I wash all my dishes by hand, and that was true because I came from an apartment. And even to this day, I just don't like the sound of a dishwasher. And he was looking at me. He says, everybody uses a dishwasher. He said, well, the one they put in the house is a rinky-dink cheapy one. I was laying sick to my stomach. I said, I can't believe this. We're never going to be able to pay. He had come again. He had been married and he had two kids. He was 44 when we got married, and he never once, like, made me feel crazy. So he probably understood how immature I was and just left. Alright, so, but I'm telling you, I thought he was crazy and wasteful. And the other thing, November, when I moved into her house, the first thing he wanted was bar stools. And I'm telling him, I said, well, let's go to Kmart. And he looked at me, he said, for a while. I said, they've got the best furniture at Kmart. Not getting furniture from Kmart, we're going to the wood furniture store. And I said, for what? He said, for bar stools. And I said, you want good heavy duty bar stools to match the interior of the wood. We have And so when we went, they were oak. They were real wood. And he stained them himself. They were beautiful. And we still have them to this day. They will last. We had such an argument over that. It took weeks for me to finally come to terms with the fact that he was right about the bar stools. And he made it fun because he said he was gonna stain it, and it was like a fun project that we did at home, so he made it fun. But when I look back at that and think that I was ready to go to Kmart and buy these bamboo oh my goodness, the thought of that. And it makes me more thankful for my husband every single day. How he just didn't chalk me up as a crazy person. So. So then somehow we ended up with a refrigerator in the garage. And what he did, he put his old refrigerator in the garage so that he could buy a brand new, fancy new one, big one for the kitchen. And I like pitched a fit. I said, "Well, what's wrong with your refrigerator?" He says, "Nothing." I said, "Well, can't we use that in the kitchen?" He said, "Because don't you want a brand new big one for the kitchen?" I said, "No, this one is fine." And it was really beginning to stress me out when I realized he is a top of the line guy, and he would do everything and anything to make sure I had the best of the best of the best. But I wasn't demanding it. And at the time, we're gonna afford this, all this, and we could. We made really good money. I had a government job. He was in sales, made a ton of commission. So that wasn't even the issue. It was the fact that he was so anxious to buy stuff. And in my mind, yes, I could buy stuff, but unless it was absolutely necessary and need, I didn't do it. So anyways, I was crazy. Then the other thing I remember, we grew up that when you went out for the day, you did all your stuff in one trip. You didn't go to thrifty drugstore, come back. You didn't go out to the grocery store and then come back. You didn't do all this stuff. You made a plan. So you didn't waste your car, gas, and waste stuff. He was the complete opposite. And we lived close to everything, so it wasn't like a huge deal. I'm gonna go get us some donuts. I said, "Okay, well, wait, what else do you have to do today?" "Oh, I have to go to Home Depot." I said, "Well, why don't you do it?" "No, because I want my donuts now." So little by little, I started realizing that he does not even care about saving energy or anything. But you know what? I was so extreme. I remember screaming now. He said, "Well, they have a sale over here on such and such. I thought it'd be fun tonight. We could have that with our supper." All this little stuff. And we're just like so close to everything. And I thought he was crazy. I said, "Are you telling me you're going out again? Again?" And he was always so nice to me. Always so very nice to me. When I look back at how crazy I was, I am so thankful for him. Because he loved me through and through.